Respective students and their parents have a new way to visit MSOE. A virtual visit is now available on the MSOE website. The new interactive tool allows prospective students to learn more about the MSOE experience, as told by our students and faculty. Another new MSOE website has been created entirely in Chinese to assist with recruiting students from that country. The fall and winter commencements featured keynote addresses from two MSOE regents, Dr. Carl Marschke, President of Innovation, and Dr. Michael Borden, President and CEO of HuffCor. More than 400 undergraduate and graduate students received their diplomas at spring commencement, joining the ranks of more than 19,000 alumni worldwide. Michael Bolger of the Medical College of Wisconsin received an honorary Doctor of Business and Economics degree. 70 teams of high school students put their academic skills to the test during MSOE's annual Opportunity Conference in November. The OP Conference offers teams of high school students an opportunity to showcase their talents in math, science, and computers. The National Fluid Power Association's Fluid Power Challenge was held at MSOE in December. Middle school students learned about fluid power hydraulics and pneumatics and gained hands-on experience while building a fluid power mechanism with real-world applicability. In the ice hockey home opener, the Raiders crushed the Concordia Falcons 9-1 in front of 600 fans at the Kern Center. The MSOE Raiders men's basketball team took on Division I power Marquette University in an exhibition game at the Bradley Center. This was the first time the two teams have competed. Basketball forward Austin Meyer became MSOE's 11th Academic All-American, as named by ESPN the magazine. The 14th-ranked Raiders knocked off the Carthage Redmen in the Midwest III Volleyball Conference Championship. MSOE won the match in three games. The Student Leadership Dinner provided an opportunity to recognize MSOE students for their service to the MSOE and larger community. Speaking at the dinner was Dr. Bernie Cohen, himself an outstanding leader and MSOE alumnus. MSOE's annual senior design shows included everything from a musical instrument for the hearing impaired to a touchless water faucet for home and medical use, and much more. These outstanding senior design team projects, class projects, and internships are an opportunity for students to synthesize everything they've learned in their time at MSOE and put it to use in a real-life application. A car designed and built by MSOE students runs at a top speed of about 58 miles per hour, weighs only 82 pounds, and squeezes out an amazing 758 miles per gallon. It's called a super mileage vehicle, and it took 11th place in a worldwide competition to make efficient single-person automobiles. Student team members poured hundreds of hours of their free time into designing, building, and testing the vehicle. Recently, it was on display at Discovery World at Pier, Wisconsin during Super Mileage Days, introduced by the team of young engineers who created it. This year's Summer in the City Alumni Reunion provided three fun-filled days of fabulous festivities, food, and friendship for the more than 450 alumni and families who attended. Dr. Roger Frankowski, retired Vice President of Academics, was honored at the Raider reception and gala for his 42 years of service to MSOE. Friends of MSOE gathered this summer for the President's and Regent's golf outings, which together raised nearly $190,000 for student scholarships. Thanks to those who supported these events through golfing, sponsorships, auctions, and raffles. In September, the Grohmann Museum hosted its first Lost Arts Festival, celebrating many of the same activities depicted in the Man at Work collection. Local artists demonstrated long-lost trades, including blacksmithing, wooden shoe carving, painting, glassmaking, and more. Regent Alex Molinaroli, President of Power Solutions at Johnson Controls, was the keynote speaker for this year's annual scholarship luncheon. Students also responded with their own messages of thanks for scholarship support. More than 120 employers came to the annual career fair in October. MSOE's engineering, nursing, and business students are in demand, despite tough economic times, and companies are looking to hire young talent to help bring them out of the recession. The January video news edition will include fall events such as fall commencement, the exhibition of lake boats opening at the Grohmann Museum, and the next Athletic Hall of Fame induction ceremony. Join us again for the next Board of Regents meeting and another edition of the Campus Video News Report.